Hello friends, this is Jimmy Singh, broker owner of Supermax Realty, 647-961-2639, or you can reach me at my website www.supermaxrealty.ca. In this video, I'm going to give you some tips how you can pay off your mortgage within next 10 to 15 years versus paying in 25 years. So friends, before we go forward, I like to share some of the stats which I come across. There was a survey done by Mortgage Professionals Canada for 2020, and they said 9.91 million homeowners are there in Canada, and out of those homeowners, 6 million have mortgages on the properties. And out of those ones, also 1.45 million people have home equity line of credits. And the survey said last year in 2019, 74% Canadians have fixed mortgages, and the average amortization of those mortgages is 21.2%. Amortization basically means, amort is a Latin word, means death of the debt. So it basically means it will require you to, 21.2 years to pay off those mortgages. That's the average mortgage amortization in Canada. And then they were also saying, out of all those mortgage holders, only 32% people voluntarily pay off their mortgages or try to make a lump sum payments annually. So let's say, out of, 6 million people in Canada, 32% are making a lump sum payment, and the average size of the lump sum payment is $19,100. And they said the average interest right now people paying in Canada is 3.14%. And another interesting thing which I learned was last year, $62 billion was the money taken out by the homeowners as equity from their home. And the average equity takeout last year was $72,000. So what were the home sellers doing with the $72,000? First, the bigger chunk, 39% of those were doing renovations, and 23% are either consolidating or paying off their debt, and 18% people are making some kind of investments. Because you have to understand, mortgage is the biggest debt Canadians have. And you have to also understand the difference between a good debt and a bad debt. Let's say, I live in my own house and I have a mortgage on it. That's a bad debt. Why? Because if I stop making payments, bank is going to take my house away. Versus if I have mortgage on my rental property, my tenant is paying for it and I'm not too worried. Because if, tenant stop making payment and I can't somehow cash flow or I can't hold it, I can easily sell, make profit out of it, right? So know your risk, know your tolerance, know your situation, know your income. And while watching this video, guys, I'm going to throw some numbers down the line. So if it's too much information, you can, pause the video, take a pen and paper and write it, because it is very critical. You will be surprised. Like, I give you an example. Let's say your mortgage is $350,000 at an interest of 4% for 30 years, term amortization. Do you know you will be paying roughly $250,000, $250,000 in interest over a course of 25 to 30 years, right? And obviously, banks love, if you keep refinancing the property and keep stretching the mortgage back to 25%. So, let's say if you want to buy a car of $70,000 and you refinance your house, that, just taking $70,000 and buying a car, technically, with all the interest over 25 years, that $70,000 loan actually cost you more than $100,000, right? So be very, very careful. And when you get a letter from the banks for refinance or, interest is coming down, sit with them, crunch some numbers, see if it makes sense in your situation. Because what happens sometime, the low interest, defeat all the purpose. Because there's penalties, the refinance cost, there's, so much other things. So, those things have to be discussed. And then if you're looking for retirement and you have a bigger property, you go to a small city, move to Toronto, from Toronto, maybe move to London, or if you're living in Brampton, Mississauga, look for cheaper options and buy a smaller property. You can buy a condo of 300,000, or maybe you can buy a townhouse in London for 400,000. That will save you substantially, and you can be debt free, fast. You know, debt free is the top priority, guys. And at the end of the day, if you have a mortgage on the property, understand this: two things, time and interest are your enemies. How, you know, if you have a mortgage, you can't, you know, fathom how much interest you will pay over the life of the mortgage. And the longer you stays with the bank, the more interest you pay. See, when we get a mortgage from the bank, all the mortgages are top loaded, front loaded. What it means is, initial 5-6 years, if you see your amortization table, that is something you can ask your banker to give. It will, you know, show you the breakdown, how much you're paying for interest, how much you're paying for principal. So let's say your monthly payment is $2,000. In beginning of the term, you will notice 60-70%, depending on your interest rate, goes to the interest. Obviously, when you're at the late cycle, of your mortgage, let's say you're in 20th year, 21 year, then mostly all the payment will goes towards your principal, right? And first tip I want to give you guys is to shorten your amortization when you have a renewal letter coming from the bank. So what it means is, let's say you have a 30-year, 25-year mortgage, and when the bank send you letter for renewal, tell him to crunch some number instead of 25 years. You know, see if you are okay with 20 years or 15 years, right? So let's say you have a 400,000 mortgage, 25-year amortization at 2.39% interest. So just by switching to 20 years, after 5 years, you will pay approximately $22,000 towards your principal, versus if you just keep at 25 years, right? So only 5-year term difference can save you roughly $22,000, which is applied directly to the principal, knocking off thousands of dollars of interest, right? Second tip you can do is accelerate your payments. So in the same example, let's say you have a 400,000 mortgage, 25-year amortization at 2.39. So what you do is, if you're making a monthly payment and after 5 years, total interest on the loan will be $44,000. And then all you have to do is call a bank and say, change it to bi-weekly. So that way you'll be making 26 payments in a year, one extra payment. And in 5 years, the difference between bi-weekly and monthly would be, you will reduce the amortization by 2 years just by switching to bi-weekly. So instead of 25 years, your loan would be paid off in 23 years. And approximately $9,500 will be applied to principal if you choose bi-weekly versus, you know, monthly payment. So that can be the second tip. Third thing you want to do is make lump sum payment. So let's say you have a mortgage of $500,000, 25 year at 3% interest. Just by doing $5,000, guys, you will pay off your mortgage in 19 years and 10 months versus 25 years. So if you find $10,000 sitting, you know, you get the money from, maybe you're doing extra hassle, you are driving Uber, you're doing your hobbies, you're making $10,000 lump sum payment annually, your mortgage will reduce to 16 years from 25 years. And if you are doing like $20,000 directly towards your principal annually, your mortgage would be paid off in 12 years. See, sometimes, you know, we think, you know, it's overwhelming. Life catches you. You are busy with your kids, your family, your business, and you don't have time. You know, we only think about mortgages. Obviously, when the renewal comes, you want to, you know, shop around for the best rate, but you lose that opportunity. So just by doing 20,000 lump sum towards your mortgage amortization will reduce from 25 years to 12 years, saving you pretty much, you know, half of the interest during the term, right? Fourth thing you can do is, you can just round up your payment. So let's say your monthly payment is, principal interest is $1,850. Make it round to $2,000. Tell the bank, instead of $1,850, take $2,000. You will be surprised how much interest you can save. This guy's bunch of mortgage saving calculators online. You can go to Scotia Bank. They have a couple of good ones. You can, you know, Google and find those ones and play with the numbers and figure out, you know, just by doing small changes, how much money you can save. And second thing you want to do is, if you you get a letter for renewal, or for whatever reason you want to refinance at a lower interest, keep making the same payment. So let's say initial your interest was 3.45 and now you know right now the interest is close to 2.1 or, you know, 1.99. So what you do is you tell the bank to keep the same payments, the higher payments which you are making initially, but obviously that way you can pay off your principal faster. Keep the same fixed payments, but get a variable rate or the lower interest rate as of today. But sit with the bank, tell him to crunch some numbers, ask him what is the cost of breaking the mortgage, refinancing, what is the appraisal cost, what is the admin fee, and see whether it's worthwhile for you to refinance, right? And fifth thing you can do is make your property work for you. So what it means basically, you know, if you have a basement apartment, you can rent the basement apartment, take all the money instead of using and paying utilities, take whole of the rent, apply towards your principal. Once your house is paid off, you know, it will, you know, make your life way easier. Or if you are in an area where you can rent your investment property or your primary residence as Airbnb income, or you have a cottage, or maybe, you know, you have a big shed at the big, you know, at the back, you can rent your shed, you know, monthly for a storage. Or if you have a big driveway and, you know, you have a lot of parking spots, so what you do is you put your parking spot for rent. So maybe your neighbor want to park his boat there and he'll be paying $100, $200. Things add up, guys. So even $1,000 applied towards the principal annually can reduce your mortgage from 25 years to 23.6 years. Just keep in mind, if you're renting your house, basement, or you're renting your room, Airbnb, obviously there's tax implication. Talk to your accountant, and obviously when you sell your house, for whatever portion, you have to pay capital gains, right? The sixth point you want to do is you want to refinance at a lower rate. And, you know, talk to your bank, see instead of 25 years, if you reduce 15 years, how much the payment would be. And obviously, if you're in prime of your earning years, it's easy to save money. Maybe you can, you know, do some sacrifices. Instead of eating out five times or four times a week, you should eat one time or two times. So that will certainly help. And just a small caveat, keep in mind, interest rate right now, mortgage is very, very cheap. In some situations, it doesn't actually make sense to pay mortgages. Why? Because, you know, some people I see have Visa cards, which are like 18%, 21%, and they have car loans, they have, you know, student loans at a higher interest. So in that situation, what you will do is basically consolidate all the debts in a single payment of the mortgage and try to pay it off. Because what you want to do is you want to pay off the high interest debts first. So obviously mortgage will save you a lot of interest, but if you have a bigger debt, why would you keep carrying, you know, 8% car loan or 21% Visa balance? Just knock it off, right? And then obviously when you have extra money, you can, you know, pay off your house off, then it will take to the next level. So next level basically means is if you have a high home equity line of credit, you can take that money if you have a solid income and put as a down payment towards your house and own investment properties and grow and, you know, become rich. And last point, guys, is obviously try to do side hustle. So maybe, you know, if you are fond of dancing, photography, monetize those hobbies. If you have a graphic designer, maybe offer your services, make cash money. Or if you have a, you know, you want to drive Uber and you want to do food catering, any, you know, side kind of business, whatever money you make every month, keep knocking off the principals. I can't, you know, re-emphasize, you know, a lot of people, you know, they get into housing, they know their mortgage, they just, you know, talk to the bank when the renewal comes. But their priority should be how I can pay my mortgage from 25 years within 10 years. So you have a $500,000 house paid off. That way you can do so much. You can have good memories with the, you know, with your family. You can travel, enjoy, focus on things which are important to you. And if you are a first time buyer, you bought a house 5-10% down, by paying your, you know, equity down, you have substantial, you know, money in your townhouse or condo. So when you make a big purchase item next time, you don't have to pay CMHC premium. That again will save you thousands of dollars. So I hope, guys, I know it's a long video, there's a lot of information, lot of numbers. So, you know, just absorb, pause the video. You know, if whatever point you like, let's say you want to think about making lump sum payments. So just pause the video, see how much you can do, calculate some numbers, go online. And if you have any questions, my number is 647-961-2639. You can always text me. And if you're looking for a good mortgage broker or a lender, I have a lot of, you know, good friends in the business, experienced brokers. I can recommend some. And if you're in a market to downsize, you know, your property, you know, so you can free up your equity, give me a call. We sell properties all over Greater Toronto Area, Golden Horseshoe, London, Kitchener-Waterloo. My number is 647-961-2639. And you can visit my website, www.supermaxrealty.ca. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a blessed day.